CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 8.
Hello children, how are you? Hope you are doing well. I am Professor Kirti Kapoor from NCERT, New Delhi. Today I am going to take up a poem with you. This poem is from NCERT's English textbook for class 8. The name of the book is Honeydew, Unit 2, and the title of the poem is Geography Lesson. Before I take up the poem with you, I want you to do one activity. I will give you 1 minute to do this activity. Go out and make a note of things that you observe around yourself. You observe the things in terms of their size, their shape, the impact that they have on you, or any other thing that you want to note down. Okay, you come back. Now, the same activity. Again, I am going to give you 1 minute to do this activity. Now, go to the terrace of your building. Be safe. Don't go alone. Take an elder with you. Be careful. Yes. Now observe the things from top. How do they look? Again, you have to make the observation in terms of their size, shape, the impact they have on you, or any other thing. Have you observed? Have you noted down your observation? Yes, I am sure you have noted down your observations. I will share my observations with you. I also did the same activity while you were doing the activity. You know, when you go up, one sees only the head or hair from the top. Isn't it? You cannot see the whole person. A person looks smaller from above. And when you are looking at a human being from below, the person's upper body looks smaller than the lower body. Isn't it? Is it your observation also? You see, when you look at things around you from below, like the tall building or the tree, they look big. They look as if they are imposing upon you. But the moment you have distance from them, like you have gone up to the terrace, they started looking small, smaller. And they become part of the entire picture. This beautiful poem shows how perspectives change when we look at things from a distance. This poem talks about perspectives. When you have a distance, your perspective is going to change. At eye level, we look at buildings, streets, and landmarks as individual objects. But from a certain height, the same structures seem part of a larger design. Now, can you imagine what your city would look like if you saw it from 10,000 feet above the ground, very high up? In any case, if you go on top of a high building, you can see the entire village, entire town. Everything looks small, small, small. They are part of the larger design. But if you go up in the aircraft, in the airplane, and look at the things, everything will look very, very small. Then the perspective has changed. But the moment you come down, you get to look at things as individual objects and your perspective changes. This is what the poet wants to tell us through this poem. Now, the title of this poem is Geography Lesson. I will read out the poem for you aloud, as you already know that poems are meant to be read aloud. When we read them aloud with proper intonation, stress, pauses, then we are getting the holistic meaning of the poem. And also, look at the words that have been used in the poem, because these words create vivid images in front of our eyes. So shall I read the poem for you? Are you ready? You also please open your books Page 34. Look at the lines that I am reading for you. First stanza. When the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had, seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile. There seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned, and without style. When the jet sprang into the sky. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. The logic of geography, that land and water attracted man, was clearly delineated when the jet reached 10,000 feet. Next stanza. When the jet rose 6 miles high, it was clear the earth was round and that it had more sea than land. But it was difficult to understand that the men on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities, and to kill. From that height, it was not clear why. With the metaphor of geography lesson, the poem hints at the meaninglessness of harboring hatred against others in our hearts. We human beings are just specks in the broader canvas of our universe. Let us go back to the first stanza and discuss about it. When the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile, there seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned, and without style when the jet sprang into the sky. So when the jet, the aeroplane in which the poet was traveling, took off, he looked at the haphazard plan of the city. Our roads are not parallel. We are going on one road and suddenly when we take a turn, we see that, you know, so many lanes and by lanes are there. So our cities are not planned. Why are they not planned? Because, you know, when the pressure of population is there, you have to provide them with amenities. So the structures come up. Structures in the form of hospitals, schools, etc. So therefore, development becomes little haphazard. So now the poet understands that it was inevitable because you have to cater to the needs of the people and accordingly the city keeps developing. So cities are not planned, they are haphazard. Now when the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. The logic of geography, that land and water attracted man, was clearly delineated when the jet reached 10,000 feet. In the first stanza, it was just 6 miles above the ground, but now the poet has reached at the height of 10,000 feet above the ground. Now he is looking at cities, countries, and he finds that all these cities and countries are developed along the rivers and lakes. You must have read it in your geography lesson also, in history lesson also, that our civilizations developed along the rivers, along the water bodies, because water is source of life. So he realized that and he could see, yes, actually our cities and our countries have developed along the rivers and the lakes. But when the jet rose 6 miles high, it was clear the earth was round and that it has more water than land. But it was difficult to understand that the men on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities and to kill. From that height, it was not clear why. The poet also realizes that our earth is round and it has more water than landmass. But he said, I am unable to understand why men on this earth hate each other. They kill each other They have built walls around cities. Why this hatred? So the poet is trying to tell us that if you have an argument with somebody, give it some time. Leave it over there. Have distance. Let it rest for 2 days, 3 days. Think about it. And when you meet next, probably you will be able to appreciate the perspective of the other person. You will understand why this difference of opinion is there. This poem is written by Zulfikar Ghosh. He has written many poems, stories and dramas for children. So therefore we now understand the metaphor of geography lesson has been used in this poem. Now I am going to do comprehension check for you. Mention two things that are clear from the height of a jet. Two things. You can go back to the poem. You can read the poem quickly. What are the two things that are clear from the height? The poet had mentioned 3-4 things. Shall I share my answer with you? Yes, it was clear why there were cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. Because civilization develops on the banks of the rivers or near the lakes. It was also clear that the earth was round, that it had more sea than land. You can read stanza 2 once again and you will find that the poet is talking about these two things in stanza 2. Now the next question. Mention two things that are not clear from the height of a jet. Go back to your stanza 3. Give it a quick read. Underline the things where the poet says not clear. Shall I share my answer with you? It was not clear why there was conflict among humans. He was not able to decipher that. He could not understand that why do human beings fight. It was also not understandable why humans had to build walls across cities, boundaries on the peripheries of our countries. Walls between two cities, two countries. He says this is not clear. If you have an argument, if you have some difference of opinion, give it a distance. Let it rest and then talk about it. You will come to some happy conclusion. Now, I want you to go back to the poem once again and underline the words which are referred at the ground level. The words are haphazard. In the first stanza, haphazard. Unplanned. He says it is clear why the city is developed in this manner. Haphazard, unplanned, without style. And come back to stanza 3. There you find negative terms such as hate, kill. So the poet has used these negative terms. They refer to the ground level. What is he trying to tell us? He says that your perspective will change when you give it a distance. At ground level or when you are very close to things, your perspective is different about that, about those things. But the moment you have distance, your perspective changes. You look at those things in a different manner. The poet has used some positive terms in the poem. Now all these positive terms are from the aerial level. When he goes up in the jet, he has used the words developed, delineated, populated, logic, attracted clearly. So the distance has given a new perspective to the poet to look at things. In this poem, you will find that the poet has used run-on lines. Now, what are these run-on lines? Run-on lines means that the poet does not end the first line with a comma or a full stop. And he has also started his lines with the lowercase. Why do you think the poet has used such things? Do you think he doesn't know how to write a poem? No, that is not the case. Was there less space on the page? That is also not true. to give us a feeling of seeing several things at a time when flying at a speed. That is why he has given run-on lines. That means his three lines go as one part. After three lines, he has put a full stop after the word had. Look at the first stanza. So that means he is looking at things in one go and he has presented his ideas in that manner. So don't think it is a prose lesson. It is still a poetry. So this is known as run-on lines. So you have learnt something new, how to present a poem. Poem can be written in any form. So you will find that generally in poems, the first word of each line begins with a capital letter. In this poem, it is not done like that. Sometimes, though the poet continues the next line without a capital letter at the beginning to signal that his or her thoughts are continuing. And this poem has been written in free verse. Now, I am going to give you another activity. Are you ready? The activity is find three or four phrases in stanzas 1 and 2. Only stanza 1 and 2, which are likely to occur in a geography lesson. You are studying your geography also? And some of the terms which come in the geography have been used by the poet in his poem. So, find out those words. I am going to give you 1 minute to do this activity. Only stanza 1 and 2. I have found out the lines. Shall I share them with you? The first is, it scaled 6 inches to the mile. Scaled 6 inches to the mile. These type of references are used in geography lesson when we are reading a map. Now, cities where the rivers ran. Your geography teacher, your history teacher must have discussed with you that cities, civilizations develop along the rivers. The valleys were populated and valleys are also populated with humans. Why? Because in valleys you have lakes and water is life. So therefore, civilizations developed in valleys as well as along the rivers. And these references you will find in your geography as well as in your history lessons. Isn't it? Did you find it? If you found it, then please mention it here. And you can share it with your geography teacher and also with your history teacher. Now we are going to work with language. We are talking about words, vocabulary that is used in this poem. Words used by the poet to describe the movement of the jet across the sky. What are the words? The words are sprang, reached, rose. Now, there are more words that can be used to describe the movement of aeroplanes. Jet, flew, climbed, traveled, soared, ascended, rocketed, or mounted. So, we are learning new words from the words given in the poem. We are learning synonyms. The poet has used only three words, sprang, reached, soar. But these words have synonyms also. Their synonyms are flew, climbed, traveled, soared, ascended, rocketed, or mounted. And you must be knowing that synonyms are not exact meanings of the word. They are close to the meaning of the word. Now, as per the context, we have to use the word. You must have observed that the poet uses the word jet instead of aeroplane. We these days use the word aircraft, aeroplane. But the poet has used the word jet. So, can we make more words with the word jet? Jet as a prefix. Jetliner. Jetliner means aircraft powered by a jet engine. Then, have you thought of another word which can start with the word jet? Jet lag, fatigue or tiredness after a long flight. The next word is jet set. Some people who fly across the globe for business or pleasure. Jet set. That means they are always ready to move. Jet engine. Engine that emits high-speed hot gases at the back when it moves forward. Then there is another word that I have come across. I am going to share it with you. Jet SAM. Now this word is not related to jet lag or jet aircraft or jet engine, because all these words were related to aeroplanes. But jet SAM is not. So what is the meaning of jet SAM? Unwanted material or goods that have been thrown overboard from a ship to lighten it and have washed ashore. So what is the difference between flotsam versus jetsam? Flotsam is when debris or things from the sea automatically come to the shore with the waves. But jetsam is when we or the people who are traveling in the ships throw those things into the sea and they come ashore. Now I am going to read a few statements. This is a listening activity and I know you are good at it. I will speak very slowly and you have to pick up the correct statement as per the poem. Okay, now you know your poem very well. In the first stanza, the poet is talking about why the cities are not planned, why are they haphazard. Okay, and in the second stanza, he talks about, you know, cities and rivers, and he finds from 10,000 above the ground that, you know, these cities and towns have developed along the rivers. And in the third stanza, he founds or he tells us that the earth is round. There is more water than land mass and we are just a speck, a little dot. But why do human beings fight? We are just a dot. From top, we have no significance. Now, I am going to read five statements. You have to tell me which are correct. The first one, there are cities where there are rivers. I read it again for you. There are cities where there are rivers. Right or wrong? Yes, this statement is correct. The second one, cities appear as they are not from 6 miles above the ground. I read it again. Cities appear as they are not from 6 miles above the ground. This is not correct. Cities are there where they are. The third one. It is easy to understand why valleys are populated. This is correct. This statement is correct. The fourth one. It is difficult to understand why humans hate and kill one another. I read it again. It is difficult to understand why humans hate and kill one another. This statement is right. The poet does not understand why humans hate and kill one another. This statement is correct. The fifth one. The earth is round and it has more sea than land. The earth is round and it has more sea than land. Yes, this is correct. We all know this. Your geography teacher also must have told you this. So, I have a writing task for you. Suggest some ways in which people on earth can live in harmony and peace. Can you suggest? Yes, of course you can. We should not argue. We should try to understand other person's perspective. Or you can add more things to it. You write a paragraph on this and you can share it with us. Draw a map of your locality or village, depicting its physical features. Yes, of course, you can draw where your school is, where is the hospital, where is the pond, where is the river. You can draw. And distances between places, like places, etc. Describe it in your own words. First you draw the map and then you describe it. That my school is just 10 minutes away from my home. The dispensary is about 500 meters from my home. There is a river at the end of the village. So you have to describe. Describe your locality or your village where you stay. First draw the map. I have a project work for you. We have learnt about geography. We have learnt about history. Now little bit of political science. Today the United Nations acts as a mediator to keep peace and order in the world. gather information about the UN and its constituent bodies and prepare a portfolio about that. You will understand how the United Nations tries to keep peace in the world. If two countries are fighting, they become the mediator. So if you do this project, you will understand that perspectives are very important, which we have learnt with the help of this poem. With this, we have come to the end of this poem. I hope you enjoyed learning this poem. Happy learning. Enjoy reading. Thank you.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo. Produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.